Sex and the City star Sarah Jessica Parker is in the country to grace the opening of a mall at the Bonifacio Global City. My partner Lexi Schulze tells us why people are calling Parker's visit as the fashion event of the year. Hi Lexi, how's it going there?
Wow, Teach, it's madness out here. I thought I'd just see a lot of fan girls, but really men, women, all ages. The department store is completely full just to catch a glimpse of Sarah Jessica Parker. I mean, really going out of their way to for this launch and its latest endeavor. The high-end mall over at Bonifacio Global City, of course, I'm talking about SM Aura. SM wanted to start with a bang with a larger-than-life celebrity who would be the perfect fit for the luxurious feel of the brand's latest installment in the more happening part of the metro. And who better to invite than Sarah Jessica Parker, a superstar in her own right with a good 50 movies or so, plus theater roles, and that's where she got her start. I mean, who can ever forget her most famous role of all? Of course, Miss Carrie Bradshaw on Sex and the City. She won 3 Golden Globes for that, 2 Emmys, and 3 SAGs. But truth be told, though, they also chose Sarah Jessica Parker, not just for her fun and fashion. She's a true patron of the arts. Sarah Jessica Parker, yep. King Jr. School in Portland, Oregon, for the Turnaround Arts Initiative. So many of her fans know that theater is really close to her heart. This year, she's coming out again off-Broadway in a play that's actually written by actress Amanda Peet, and she'll be starring beside Blythe Danner, the mom of Gwyneth Paltrow. But Teej, really, I mean, this is the experience today is really unmatched. People are just really lining up and waiting to see her. It's really quite unbelievable. And to think she's such a big star, but from the word in the streets, she is so low maintenance. I mean, instead of using the limo that they got for her, she's actually chosen to use a van with her crew. She refused to stay in the presidential suite of the hotel. She wants a small room. She smiles at everybody. I mean, we're just really all excited to see her right now. DJ?
You can tell her I'm fine to use the limo if she wants to use a van. But
would you like to?
But tell us, what?
It's beautiful, but really, I guess she's really one of these people who just wants to hang with her crew. She smiles and stops and smiles at everybody. She says please and thank you. I mean, just really salt of the earth superstar, I suppose.
Well, what kind of people are out there today? I mean, well, there is work, but I wouldn't be surprised if some people who work in the area skip the last few hours.
You know what? It's actually the mall opening. She is here to cut the ribbon for the department store area.
Mm-hmm.
So she's the guest of honor. So this is also the mall opening. So dignitaries are here. Well, of course, a lot of people actually work in the mall. They're all here. They're excited to see her. You've got people from society. You've got all sorts. I mean, everybody's here. I thought it would be just a small sort of press conference type thing, but no. This is huge. And apparently, she's going to be coming in paired up jeans and a fun shirt. You know, this is how low maintenance she is. And well, we'll see how it goes. I'll let you know, because at this point, the traffic in this area in Bonifacio Global City is really quite mad because this is the first opening day.
Right.
So we'll see if she even makes it over during her call time.
All right. Well, also keep your eye out for a Mr. Big spotting just in case. Just in case. All right. Thanks so much. That's Lexi Schulze talking to us from the big mall opening at Bonifacio Global City in Taguig. So do watch out for the heavy traffic that is ongoing there right now.